This young man filmed the protests in Myanmar, despite the ongoing violent crackdown by police and military. Civilians there are risking their lives to show the world what is going on inside the country. A fellow protester was shot during a demonstration. He did not survive. The violence continues in Myanmar. As the world weighs a response, the death toll rises. Every day brings new scenes of brutality. But the people remain defiant. Protesters continue to stand up to the military, laying their lives on the line. Young people are harnessing the power of the internet, taking to social media to call for support and mobilize. They gather information on the latest whereabouts of the security forces and share it with the people on the front lines of the protests. One programmer has created an app that lists companies with ties to the military so people know to boycott their products. People from Myanmar who moved overseas are also doing their part. They are life, are using the internet and social media to fight back against the country's powerful military. We follow the digital resistance taking place in Myanmar during the first 2 months after the coup. February 1st, 2021, the Myanmar military takes power, seemingly out of nowhere. Politicians are detained one after another. They are members of the NLD, the National League for Democracy, led by Aung San Suu Kyi. In the 3 weeks following the coup, the number of protesters swelled into the millions. This man is a member of a youth group that staged one of the first rallies. February 28th, the situation takes a drastic turn for the worse. The military launches an all-out crackdown. At least 18 civilians are killed, according to the UN. State-run TV reports it was only in response to violence by protesters. But video from the scene tells a different story. One of the sites of violence was a neighborhood in Yangon, the country's largest city. Mobile phone location data shows that many people had crowded into one particular area by around 9 a.m. A video shows what was happening on the ground. Security forces appear to drive the protesters into a corner.
From the start of their alignment to reaching us would take about only 5 minutes. Their head officer shouted once about get dispersed, and they rushed forward at once. And together with it, they threw some grenades and tear gas bombs. We haven't even started the protest.
Throughout the country, the military responded to protests with violence. Video captured soldiers turning their guns on civilians. Why did the military suddenly resort to force against defenseless protesters? Some suspect a rising sense of crisis among the leadership. The military may be worried that the growing number of police officers and public servants abandoning their posts could undermine its authority. A sense of urgency was evident in a speech by the top commander. Since then, the military has only escalated its crackdown, and the death toll continues to climb. This video was posted on social media. It shows police officers dragging the body of a protester. The victim was an 18-year-old medical student. But amid the circumstances, some young people are finding new ways to resist. The student who was killed during a protest was part of a medical workers group. Mon Mon is also a member.
ဆဲအာနာကျန်အစုဖတ်တာဒီဆလောက်ပြတဲ့ပြည်သူတွေကိုဖြုတ်ခွဲလာတယ်အဲမိဆက်လက်တွေကအင်မတန်အကြမ်းဖက်လာတယ်ရက်ဆက်ကျဉ်းကျုပ်လာတော့တွေ့ရတယ်ဘာမှကြိုတင်အသိပေးခြင်းမရှိဘဲနဲ့ပြတ်ခတ်တာတွေတလက်အဆင့်နဲ့ပြတ်ခတ်တာတွေကြောင့်ပြည်သူတွေအသက်ပေးနေရတယ်ဆိုတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့က ုပ်ပြည်သူတွေကိုကာကွယ်ဖို့ကျွန်တော်တို့လှုပ်ရှားဖို့လိုအပ်တယ
် The group is fighting back using digital tools.Small teams survey urban areas to collect information on the latest whereabouts of the military and police and map their precise locations. They immediately share their findings on an app, allowing people to avoid potentially dangerous spots during protests.
ဆုတ်ဆုတ်ပြီးတော့ဟောနောက်ဆုတ်မလဲပေါ့နော်ဆုတ်ပြီးတော့ကိုယ်တွေတောင်းဖို့ပြေးဖို့ဆိုတဲ့နေရာလေးတွေတော့ရှာထားဖို့လိုမယ်အဲ့
တော့ခုကျွန်တော်တို့လုပ်ခဲ့တဲ့ plan ကတော့မြန်မာထဲမှာအဆူလေးဖွင့်ပြီးတော့ဆန္ဒအကုန်လုံးပြတ်ရမယ်ဆိုတဲ့ plan ပါနော်
The group also makes videos with information on the protests and shares them on social media.
ကျွန်တော်မြန်မာနိုင်ငံမှာ digital media ဟာကုန်နေအကြီးတဲ့အပိတ်ခံထားရဲဆိုလားလဲပါတယ်။ဒါပေမဲ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ပြည်သူတယောက်ချင်းစီကဒါ media သမားတွေဖြစ်လာမယ်ဆိုရင်ကျွန်တော်တို့ပြည်သူတွေမသိနိုင်တဲ့တည်င်းအချက်လက်ဆိုတာရှိလာမှာမဟုတ်ပါဘူး။ပြည်သူတွေကိုဖန်ကန်တဲ့တည်င်းအချက်လက်တွေအချိန်နဲ့တည်င်းညီပေးနိုင်အောင်ဒီနေရာမှာဝိုင်းဝန်းစူးစမ်းလုပ်ကိုင်နေကြတာဖြစ်ပါတယ
်။ One programmer in his 20s is trying to hit the troops where it hurts. He's developing an app that could help cut off funding for the military. The program lists companies with ties to the military and urges people to boycott their products.
The program you do it, Pasania, sit down to the solution, eh? You don't look at them, Tidani, the Tidani, the Tidani, the Tidani,
The military is trying to shut down this digital resistance movement by blocking internet access. And that's where the overseas Myanmarese community has stepped in to help.
Oh, hello. 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 Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
This man has sent more than 600 mobile phone SIM cards from Thailand back home to Myanmar.He hopes this will help people get around the internet restrictions. And he's not alone. More than 1,000 people originally from Myanmar are pitching in. And more help is coming from the other side of the world. This programmer, originally from Myanmar, is currently based in New York.He's launched a website with information on victims of the crackdown. He's working with friends back home to get the latest information.
The you know, topmost priority is the death tolls. Like, a lot of people are being killed, so we keep track of the you know, death tolls so we could you know, update the dashboard. All of their voices have been like, a little bit silent because of the internet cut off at this time, and I can speak out for them.
People in Japan are also joining the digital resistance movement. Twenty-nine-year-old Mimi is one of them.
これはウェブサイトをみんなで一斉にアクセスして、もうアクセス数が多すぎてて、それ以上アクセスできないようにしてます。
Mimi is working with a group of tech-savvy people around the world to stage a digital attack on the military. They're trying to crash the military's servers through collective action. This isn't the only form of online protest. Another group accessed the Ministry of Information's website and posted an image of the three-finger salute alongside the message, "Reject the coup." For Mimi, the digital resistance movement is personal. Mimi's younger siblings have taken to the streets in Myanmar. Mimi sees parallels between the protest movement and the Shibazakura flower. Mimi is meeting with other people from Myanmar living in Japan. Members of the group say they are distraught by the constant flow of violent footage on social media. The meeting was organized by Win Chow. He's lived in Japan for over 30 years. He has a proposal for the members. Every day, people in Myanmar are posting countless photos and videos of the violence. Win Chow suggests Mimi and her friends gather as much footage as they can and verify its authenticity. His plan is to present it to the world as proof of the ongoing police and military violence.
ตัวนี้ครับเหรอมวยเฉลี่ยเนี่ยมาเยอะใจเย็นบ่หลอกป่าเนี่ยใช่ครับเนาะสิมักแซ่เอาเด้อตรุอ่ะติว่าพี่เอาไปแล้วเด้อตรุอัตติอะละหาบ่เผ็ดเอาละหาดูว่าหาดูว่าตาวเว้ยสิเอาเด้อเอาตัวเองเอาดีดิกะดีดิ Win Chao is in regular contact with people back home who tell him about the daily violence.
No, please don't try.
How many people are shot dead by the military?
ほんとと殺されたの方は19歳、20歳、そういう人たちなんで、もうね、これはもう国を壊したっていうの一緒じゃないですか。国の宝物、若者っていうのは国の宝物だから。
These days, Win Chao supports the protesters back in Myanmar online. He was once on the front lines of the fight for democracy himself. In 1988, Myanmar, then called Burma, was ruled by a military dictatorship. A massive anti-government movement erupted, calling for democracy. At the time, Win Chao was a graduate student. He took part in the protests. The military responded with deadly force. One of Win Chao's friends is why the military repeatedly resorts to such brutality. Mimi is heeding Win Chao's advice and searching social media for evidence.
ダウンロードするって書いとかないので、一応下ろしといて、後で夜とかに仕事終わるときにそれをダウンロードするようにしてます。で、これだと昨日のここに警察がいるんですけど、で、国民が作ったバリアを警察が火つけたんですね、ここ。
A string of cases of arson have been reported from across Myanmar. The military has said civilians are responsible. But Mimi is searching for evidence that suggests otherwise. The barricade can be seen on the lower part of the screen. Standing nearby is a man who appears to be a member of the security forces. Soon after, white smoke starts to rise. In less than a minute later, there are flames. Many videos are posted without details, so Mimi goes through each one to verify what they're showing. For example, this one did not include any information on location, so Mimi reached out to the person who posted it. The videos are often graphic and hard to watch. But that doesn't keep Mimi from going through as many as possible. March 3rd, just over a month since the coup, the military continues to train its guns on civilians. A civilian took this video at great personal risk. Experts analyzed the footage and say it shows the security forces using submachine guns and assault rifles. Protesters are gunned down, one after another. The United Nations says at least 38 people were killed on March 3rd alone, calling it the bloodiest day since the coup. But at the Security Council, there's a split. Countries like the US and Britain condemn the military. Others like Russia and China are calling for Myanmar's sovereignty to be respected. This rift has made it difficult for the Security Council to adopt a resolution. All the while, the situation in the country only gets worse. Meanwhile, someone has sent Win Chow an urgent message asking for help. Young protesters are trapped in an area of Yangon, surrounded on all sides by the military.
Hey, 寝たら危ないよ。来るよ。
Hello? Hello?
Desperate to help in any way, Win Chau and his wife start calling nearby foreign embassies.
Hello, which embassy you are speaking? How may I help you?
I'm sorry, I'm called from Japan and now in Myanmar, Sanjiao township, so very dangerous. Please, you help our students and our nationalities.
Yeah, that's
the
information we already have, so don't worry,
I'm
just
done
meeting.
Win Chau could only watch the events of March 3rd from afar. One death from the day hit him particularly hard.
まあ、この子がエンジェルです。かわいそう。
チェーゼン、also known as Angel, was 19 years old. She took part in demonstrations in Mandalay, the second biggest city in the country. She was a constant presence on the streets, encouraging her fellow protesters.She was on the front lines of a protest when she was shot. Angel was known for her love of singing and dancing. She joined the protests after the coup and posted this message on social media.If I die,I want my organs and eyes to be donated. The words suggest she was ready to sacrifice her life for the cause. Hundreds of people attended her funeral. They took to social media, posting countless messages mourning her death and protesting the military.The messages quickly spread around the world. Angel was soon seen as something of a martyr. Then, the military did something that almost beggars belief.
မမရေဗျာကျေစင်လေးရဲ့အုတ်ကူကိုလာဖွင့်သွားတယ်ဆိုရတော့သိကြပါရခင်ဗျာ
The military announced it had exhumed Angel's body and conducted an autopsy to determine the cause of death It announced the results on state-run televisionThe report claimed that the bullet that killed Angel did not belong to the police. It suggested that since the police were facing the protesters, they could not have shot her in the back of the head, which was where the bullet was found. The report went on to suggest the following.
ဒီနေ့အေးချမ်းမှုကိုမလိုလားသူများကပရိပက္ခပုံမှုကြီးထွားလာစေရန်လောက်ကျန်ဖန်တီးမှုဖြစ်နိုင်ကြောင်းသုံးသပ်ရရှိကာနောက်ွယ်မှာကြိုးကန်ဆောင်ရွက်နေသူများအားဖော်ထုတ်အရေးယူနိုင်ရေးဆောင်ရွက်လျက်ရှိကြောင်းတင်ပြရရှိပါရယ်ခင်ဗျာ
Win Chau is furious that the military is once again denying responsibility for a civilian death just like it did in 1988
天国から彼女が
ね、誰が殺したっていうのを分かってもらいたいっていうことです。
But is there evidence that can debunk the military's claim? Win Chao has called on the youth group in Japan to help him look for videos of the moment Angel was shot.
Jason Lee, video quiz, Tamashi.
The group starts compiling videos and photos that could provide clues as to what really happened. This includes footage of protests and images of military and police weapons. What were the circumstances in which Angel was shot? NHK teamed up with Amnesty International and military experts to gather videos and photos taken at the scene. We used satellite imagery to pinpoint where the footage was recorded. Then we referenced eyewitness accounts of the day to verify exactly what happened. The protesters have gathered at an intersection in central Mandalay. Angel is among them, leading the chants. About 70 meters ahead, security forces are blocking the road. When we zoom in on the image, we can see the word police on the shields. We also see some soldiers wearing camouflage. They are believed to be from the army. ...11:50 a.m. A unit starts shooting. We found a photo of the scene. We spoke to military experts to identify the weapon types. A police officer is carrying a shotgun, and a soldier has an assault rifle. The protesters respond by using smoke screens. But they are forced to gradually retreat as security forces continue to advance. The crowd is driven back as far as 31st taken during this 30-second interval. Angel can be seen running with her back to the military and police. And then... multiple bangs, and Angel collapses. To determine where the sounds came from, we examined another video from the same time frame. This one has clearer audio. After NHK had the bang sounds analyzed by an acoustics laboratory and weapons experts, we determined that the bang coinciding with Angel falling down may have come from an assault rifle. This would match the account of a man who was taking photos nearby.
ที่ว่าจีตันนี่ก็ตอนนี้ก็เนี่ยแต่ผมเข้าได้ตันนี่ไปหาไปตันก็ที่นี่แล้วต้องเรียนตรงนั้นแล้วย้อนกันจ้าได้มาคือตอนนั้นเนี่ยตาวิเชียนเนี่ยที่จะเป็น
Win Chow has also tracked down someone who was near Angel when she was shot. This person was among the protesters at the site. He says once the security forces started shooting, the protesters began to retreat. And that's when Angel was hit. The evidence suggests that Angel was shot from behind by an assault rifle. This potentially contradicts the military's claim. On March 27th, Myanmar's military celebrated Armed Forces Day. It held a large-scale ceremony to mark the occasion. Japan, along with the US and most European countries, did not send any representatives. In fact, officials from only 8 foreign countries, including Russia and China, attended the event. Senior General Minon Lang stressed the legitimacy of military rule to viewers both inside and outside the country. At the same time, the military issued a chilling warning to citizens who would continue to take to the streets. You should learn from those who died miserable deaths before you that there is a danger of being shot in the head or back. But the people were undeterred. Citizens across the country staged protests at the same time as the ceremony. The young people engaged in the digital resistance were among those on the streets. But the military responded with more violence. More than 100 people were killed. Children were among the victims. The day's events shocked the world. The administration of US President Joe Biden says it supports the, quote, democratic aspirations of the people of Myanmar. And the government has announced the suspension of all US trade and investment involving Myanmar.
It's terrible. It's absolutely outrageous. And based on the reporting I've gotten, an awful lot of people have been killed totally unnecessarily.
But this has not been enough to pressure the military to stop its brutal crackdown. In Japan, Mimi continues her fight on the front lines of the digital resistance.